Let's get to the latest updates of the investigation into the toolkit case by the Delhi police. The climate activist Greta Thunberg has now tweeted showing solidarity with the toolkit case accused Disha Ravi. Greta in her tweet said peaceful protests and freedom of speech is non-negotiable human rights with a hashtag stand with Disha. This as activist and main accused of the case. Disha is in police custody since Sunday for allegedly sharing the toolkit on social media. In fact, her bail plea is listed in the Patiala House Court today. On Friday, a Delhi court sent Disha Ravi to 3 days of judicial custody. The police told court that Disha was evasive during her previous interrogation and tried to shift the blame to co-accused Shantanu Muluk and Nikita Jacob. The police further said that both the accused have been summoned on February 22nd and that the three will be made to face each other and will be jointly interrogated. Let me take this across now to Anisha Mathur, who's joining us with the latest legal updates on the story. Anisha, good morning. We'll have to, of course, wait and watch to see if Disha Ravi gets any relief. But yesterday, the Delhi court already remanded her to 3 days of judicial custody.
Well, yes, good morning, Akshita. Today is going to be a very crucial day to see what exactly is the argument that is brought forward by the police as well as by Disha Ravi's lawyers. Remember, she is one of the people who is facing conspiracy as well as possible sedition charges in this investigation that the police is doing. Yesterday's remand application by the police very clearly said that they have found certain elements of that controversial toolkit on her laptop. She's been evasive during questioning, that she has tried to shift the blame to the co-accused, that is Shantanu and Nikita Jacob. And what is going to be very important for today's bail hearing is the fact that the police has claimed, has said very clearly that she is being sent to judicial custody for now because her police custody remand will once again be requested on February 22nd once the other co-accused reach Delhi, because that is the day that they have been summoned for questioning. So this, remember, is only the initial stages of the investigation. The police is looking into a lot of things. They have said that they are looking into evidence that this was an entire planned conspiracy to malign India, to defame India, and there are several other persons who may be involved. Possible Khalistani links have also been raised, alleged by the Delhi police, and a lot of investigation is going on. Of course, outside of court and within the court, we've seen a lot of arguments being made about why the sedition charge being laid at the door of an activist who was talking about supporting the farmer agitation. We've seen, as you just pointed out, Greta Thunberg, who's a climate change activist, also speaking out in support of Disha Ravi. But this entire controversy had begun because Greta Thunberg's tweet, which had revealed the toolkit, which seems to indicate that there could be a planned move to have this kind of protest, both on social media and outside, with regard to not only the farmer protest, but now the police are saying this could possibly be a deliberate conspiracy to defame India. So a lot of investigation still to come. And today's hearing will be very crucial to see what else the police have in their arsenal and what exactly are the legal arguments that Disha Ravi's lawyers bring in. Because yesterday they had said that there is no reason to keep her in custody, that anything that police needed has already been sealed and questions have been answered.
The police perhaps is going to reiterate what they said in court yesterday, which is that she's been evasive during questioning so far and that they want to confront her with the other accused also in this case. We'll be tracking what happens in the Delhi court today. Anisha, for the moment, thank you for joining us.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.